Hey, YouTube shooting people. So I want to just bullshit with you for a while. I've been doing a lot of shooting this summer so far. I'm sure you've seen the videos. Some of it's better than others. I'm going to give you my take on the evolution of my shooting. While I do that, I guess I'll take this guy down. This is my Smith & Wesson 1911. This is my primary gun. It has been safety checked. There's no magazine in it. I do it anyway. There's nothing in the chamber. Safe direction. Fire. Weapons clear. This is my primary gun. I gotta tell you, there's a lot of rounds hit through it now. For me, there's a lot of rounds. I believe I'm pushing, I think I'm over the 7,000 mark, and that's just based on the number of bullets that I bought to reload. It's shooting it quite a bit. So it stood up. The only issue I've had with it is the plunger tube got a little bit loose. We'll check that right now while I'm talking to you. Which is just standard. You know, people think you're going to get a gun and you're going to shoot it and it's just going to be fine forever. That's just not true. I mean, it's a mechanical device, and you got to expect from the fact that this thing is, you know, it's going like this, wham, you know, with some serious force, wham, 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 wham. Things are going to get loose. It's just the physics of it. So let's take it apart. I'll take a look at it, and I want to talk to you sort of about the evolution of my shooting. This is the year back in January, or very early in the year, I said this is the year I wanted to become a better shooter. And I think I've actually started to become a better shooter. I've also realized that there's so much more to learn about shooting. Besides the mechanics of shooting, there's a whole aspect of a mental game which I've yet to master. I don't know if I ever will. I'll give it a try, but I really don't know if I ever will. We'll have to just see how that all works out. I think guys that really excel and wind up to the master level shooters can do it a little bit better. What I mean by a mental aspect of shooting, I mean really when you're presented with a stage. I'm talking about competitive shooting. You know, I'm not interested in the fantasy of shit hits the fan so much. You know, I'm just talking about competitive shooting for now. Fun stuff you're supposed to be doing to have fun and relax. You know, it's like bowling with guns as far as I'm concerned. It's really the mental aspect of when you're presented with a scenario or a stage, a course of fire. How do you approach that? You know, how do you think through it? I think I put together good plans, but when the beep goes off, you know, the timer goes off, and the buzzer goes beep, my plan tends to disappear, and I just want to hose everything. It's fun. So when I was really looking at my shooting, and by the way, videoing your shooting is really worthwhile, especially if you're the GoPros are fun, so you have the helmet cam. It's kind of a neat perspective, but it's not terribly informative. If you can get somebody to actually film you while you're shooting and sit down and honestly and critically look at that shooting, what does it look like, what did you do, what are you doing wrong, you can actually learn a lot about your technique and form. It's actually a good way to get some instructional or form issues really corrected. You're exposed to a lot of shit while you're cleaning a gun. Smarten up and protect yourself a little bit so you can shoot until you're really old. Anyway, so when I looked at my shooting through videos and through looking at my scores, and you can analyze your scores in terms of what your times were, how many points down, so misses, bad shots you made, etc. You can analyze that based on the score reporting. and that you get from even a club match. And you can sort of start to identify deficits in your shooting. One area has had some deficits in was points down for, and so it really points down mostly in terms of accuracy. And that's really effective because when you're shooting, you're trying to shoot real fast. And if you've ever tried to shoot real fast, you'll note that it's much more difficult to shoot accurately when you're trying to shoot fast. So you have to find that sweet spot and be able to shoot quickly while maintaining accuracy. So what I've done recently is really focus on the accuracy, and I can tell you, I brought down my points down and have come down a lot. My time has suffered, so I've kind of gone from one extreme to the other. Now I got to find that sweet spot. It's fun to do. Shot in a match yesterday with Mr. J-Rock. It was way down in New Bedford, Mass. Really nice course of fire. I enjoyed the course of fire immensely. I did not enjoy the weather. Man, I gotta tell you, I think it was about 92 degrees at least, and that wouldn't bother me as much as the fact that the humidity was on my iPhone from the Weather Channel app. The humidity was 99%. That really affected my shooting. I think the remedy for that is trying to acclimate yourself to it, get used to it a little bit more, because we have the New England Regionals coming up, etc. The evolution of a shooter is really an interesting kind of thing. It really is kind of a journey, and I'm talking about trying to shoot in competitions. I don't consider myself particularly good at competitive shooting. I do it for myself, for my own relaxation and enjoyment, and so I'm only really competing with myself. If I see I did well on the scoreboard, that's just a bonus for me. But you always like to, if you're honest with yourself, you're usually your own sort of harshest critic, of course, right? So for me, the criticism this match was the fact that not only did I, well, my accuracy was pretty damn good. I was happy with that. But I slowed down too much. I did too many makeup shots trying to make sure I was down smaller. So, the trade-off didn't work well for me. I would have been better off with less makeup shots and a little points down because, one point down is just a half a second. So do you really want to burn a half a second on a target just to save that much? It's the payoff's probably not worth it, if you get what I'm saying. Let's see. What I've learned about guns, the more you shoot, the more you learn. What I've learned about guns is you need a gun. I don't think there's any gun out there that's not accurate enough to be used in, for instance, IDPA. So you can buy, whatever kind of gun you're into. I'm talking about a modern, center fire handgun. The question is reliability. I have to say that for the most part, most guns I've seen out there are certainly reliable right out of the box. I don't see a lot of failures. I see problems with magazines, stuff like that. That's not necessarily the gun's fault. I see some problems with reloads every once in a blue moon. Now, I'll tell you that this gun I mentioned with all those rounds through it, it's well over 7,000. I can actually sit back and go through my receipts and figure that out. The only thing that ever came loose on this was this plunger tube got a little bit loose, and all I did was take a restaking tool. At the end of the season, after the New England Regionals, I'll rip this out and put a new one in here. At the end of this, but it got loose, and it just needed to be restaked. There's a restaking tool that you can use, and I'll show you how to do that in a separate video when I replace it. Pretty straightforward. I want to thank my buddy Chrome Freak. I talked to Mike about this a little bit, got some advice about whether I should just restake it. He recommended changing it, which is definitely the right thing to do, but I didn't want to change it basically right before a match, so I just restaked it, and it's solid as hell. And I shot probably, since I restaked it about a week ago, I think I shot about 600 rounds through this gun. So it's a beast. It's really done well. I'm happy with it. The shock buffs. This shock buff now has about 1,000 rounds through it. It looks pretty good. I don't know. Well, you can see that. No issue so far. Can I tell a difference? Not at all. I think these are, I don't know, maybe they keep your gun from getting really beating the crap out of it, but I haven't seen too much difference. So I'll just keep trying it. What I want to do is shoot this one until it fails, to see when it does fail, basically about a round count, and we'll figure that all out, and I'll get back to you on that. So the shock buffs, I don't buy the argument that, oh, this thing makes you recoil less. By the way, I'm not recoil shy. I don't mind recoil. As a matter of fact, recoil is kind of irrelevant. What's most important is your grip and ability to control that recoil. All guns recoil. If you have more recoil, it doesn't matter. As long as the sight is returning back to this, if this is the front sight, if it's returning back to the same place, you can get your second shot in there. We talked a little bit about guns and gun reliability. If you shoot a lot, eventually your gun's going to fail. It's made out of parts that move, and you know, that's just the way it is, man. So you might want to think about having some backups or spare parts, having either a backup gun that you could take with you so you don't lose your match entrance fee, so it has to be in the same class, or coming up with a backup gun full stop. Some people actually have two identical guns that they can do. Those are really pretty hardcore people. But yeah, pretty happy so far. I'm looking forward to the remaining of the season, shooting through fall. I've certainly met some really knowledgeable, nice people. Some people from YouTube, of course, Bones on campus, J-Rock, Mr. J.M. Fitch, VVV Eroc, E-R-O-C, is a shooter that shoots with us regularly. I'm happy to report that J-Rock's joined the same gun club that I shoot at a lot, so I sponsored him. That was fun, and so he can go there and shoot till his heart's desire, which is good. And it's fun to sponsor him. He's a good guy. Who else? Gil, I think you really suck. Great guy. I'm looking forward to shooting with you, Gil, honestly, and a bunch of other folks. There's one guy that I've never shot with, but I want to shoot with him at some point, or just meet up with him. Hopefully we'll meet up with him soon. He's a Stripey McCatpus. Some of you might know him as Stripey McCatpus. Now, I want to shoot with him just because he posted a video yesterday of him shooting in this super dapper vest. And he, you know, it was just, it was a fashion statement that was just beyond description. Go check out his video. It was pretty good. He was doing some shotgun tricks, so take his shotgun challenge. I certainly will be. But, first I got to find one of those vests, because it was pretty neat. He looked like he worked for the DPW yard, and yeah, I'm just busting your balls, Stripey. You know it. And That's about it, man. I'm just rambling while I'm cleaning guns. Do I clean my gun every time I shoot? No, I don't. I try to wipe it down, like wipe the outside of it down. If you're shooting, you're really sweaty on a 1911, you can get some rust here. So make sure you wipe all that down before you stick it in the safe, but other and just wipe the outside out off of it. But now only I shoot it like I clean it like when I get around to it, or when it starts to have malfunctions, then I'll clean it. Otherwise, I just don't. If you shoot a lot, you just don't have the time to clean it that much. And honestly, you can see the level I'm cleaning now. I'm not exactly going mental here. I'm gonna run a rag of the poppies down it, and that'll be it. That's clean enough. So that's all I got for you. Talk to you later.